This is how to use bond energies and a few correction factors to determine the heat of formation of something unusual. Use the heat of formation table and bond energies to determine the heat of formation of 1,1 dibromoethate. All right, first, let us write exactly what a formation reaction is. A formation reaction is the formation of one mole of material from elements in their standard state. So, I will need carbon to make this material. I will need 2 moles of carbon as a solid. I will also need some bromine, 2 of them, to make it. And the standard state of bromine is Br2 as a liquid. I will also need some hydrogen. The standard state of hydrogen is H2 as a gas. Now I have a balanced formation reaction. Okay, unfortunately, I cannot use the value for the heat of formation for this material. That's what I'm trying to solve for. But I can use bond energies to estimate. So what I will do is I will write this reaction again, but this time I'm going to write all my materials in the gas phase, because that's where you can use bond enthalpies to figure out an estimate for a reaction. Now this time I'm going to write the structure out so we can look at the bonds that we need to break minus the bonds that we need to form. So now we'll use bonds broke minus bonds formed to estimate the delta H for this reaction, where everything is in the gas phase. So I will wind up breaking nothing for the carbon because it's already broken, but I will break a bromine-bromine bond. I will also break a hydrogen-hydrogen bond, and I will form 2 carbon-bromine bonds, a carbon-carbon double bond, and 2 carbon-hydrogen bonds. Notice how I've got positive signs for the bonds I'm breaking and negative signs for the bonds that I'm forming. Okay, now let me look up the values. 193 plus 436 minus 2 times 276 minus 612 minus 2 times 413. Okay, when I do the math for this, I find out the delta H of my reaction is equal to minus 1,316 kilojoules. I'm sorry, that's 61. I'm dyslexic. 61. There we go. Kilojoules per mole. And that is for this reaction right here. Okay. The next application is to use Hess's law to get to the reactions that we want. So I will rewrite what I had above. I know that the reaction of 2 carbons in the gas phase plus a bromine in the gas phase plus a hydrogen in the gas phase gives me Br2 C double bond CH2 in the gas phase. And I've calculated that amount to be minus 1,316 kilojoules. Alright, that is not the reaction I want, though. I want the formation reaction, where the 2 carbons are in the solid phase, the bromine in its standard state is liquid phase, hydrogen's fine in gas phase as a standard state, and my material, I am trying to find the gas phase heat of formation. So, I've got to get from the reaction I have the enthalpy for to the reaction I want. I'm going to have to apply some correction factors. I want to get rid of my 2 carbons in the gas phase, so I'll write this on the product side, and I want 2 carbons in the solid state. Alright, the enthalpy of change of 1 mole of carbon going from solid to gas is 716.681. I have two of them, so I know the enthalpy of this reaction will be 2 times 716.681. I also want my bromine to not be in the gas phase. I would like it in the liquid phase. So I will write it like this, and I notice that to get from gas to liquid cost me 30.91 kilojoules. Alright, now notice when I add these three reactions up, 1, 2, and 3, I get the reaction I want. The 2-carbon gas phase cancel out, the bromine in the gas phase cancels out, and what I'm left with right here on the reactant side is exactly what I wanted, and on the product side what I'm left with is just what I wanted. So if I can add the reactions to get the reaction I want, I'm also allowed to add the enthalpies. So to find the heat of formation, I will take reaction 1, which is 1,316, and I will add 2 of reaction 2, 2 times the 716.681, and I will also add 30.91, and when I do that math, I now have a value of 103.272. And since the best sort of accuracy we have is just to the integers place, I notice that delta heat of formation for 1,1-dibromoethane is 103 kilojoules per mole. That was complicated, but it's not so bad when you look at the pieces.